All right, well, it's November, and since our last update, Google has released quite a few new features for Google Assistant speakers, displays, and the Google Assistant on your phones. Now, before we dive into the new features, a word of warning. If you live outside the United States or you live in the US but do not use the US English version of the Google Assistant, some of the features demoed in this video may not have rolled out to you just yet. First up, let's talk about podcasts. Now, podcasts are something that have become increasingly important to a lot of people out there, helping make their routines throughout the day better, like cleaning, cooking, driving, etc. And podcasts have also become an increasingly important part of the assistant experience. Earlier this year, Google relaunched its Google Podcasts app on both Android and iOS, as well as made it the only podcast app that integrated with the Google Assistant. If you want to learn more about it, we did a video on it that I'll link here in the video and below in the description. Now, Google knows that while Google Podcasts is a great service, there are other podcast services out there that people may want to listen to podcasts from, like Stitcher, Spotify, etc. So Google has started to roll out third-party podcast service support for the Google Assistant, starting with Spotify. To change your default podcast service that you want the Google Assistant to use, go into Assistant Settings, scroll down to the new podcast section, and then you can link your Spotify account and make that the default provider for podcasts. Next up, let's talk about the broadcast feature with Google Assistant devices. Google earlier this year announced the ability to broadcast to a specific Google Assistant device or room within your home. That feature has now started to see a wide rollout on a variety of Google Assistant devices, and it works basically like this. You say the trigger word, then you say broadcast, and then you say either the specific speaker you want to broadcast your message to or the room name in your home that you want to broadcast your message to. Here's an example. Broadcast to the living room, dinner is ready.
All right, broadcasting to living room.
Next up, Google has rolled out a major feature change for the routines feature of the Google Assistant by giving us two new routines, home and away. Google can use multiple types of devices in your home like your phone, Nest Guard, Secure Tag, thermostats, and the Yale Lock to determine if you're home or away. They use this presence detection to enable you to do things with these routines like turn off all the smart lights in your home when no home member is home, or to turn off the indoor security cameras when a home member comes in. To get this started, open up the Google Home app, select Routines, and then select either the Home or Away routine at the top. You'll see in the How to Start section the ability to use presence detection. You'll need to enable location access for your mobile phone tied to your Google account to get it to work. You can select what you want to happen to devices in your home once Google detects that you've left home or just arrived, like automatically turning up the thermostat, turning on the lights, etc. Next up, Disney Plus is now available on Google Nest displays, so you can ask the Google Assistant on your display, for example, to play the latest episode of The Mandalorian. To get this to work, open the Google Home app, click Settings, scroll down to Video, and then link your Disney Plus account to the Google Assistant, and then you'll be able to watch Disney Plus content on your Google Assistant displays. Now, speaking of assistant displays, Google has started to roll out a pretty fundamental change to assistant displays in general. They're rolling out a brand new user interface for assistant displays, a dark theme, and then finally, the ability to see calendar events from multiple Google accounts, such as your home or work Google account. The new home screen is designed to be contextual, only showing the most relevant things to you based on a few factors like your habits or the time of day. The new UI is now designed around tabs, and there are five main ones: time of day, home control, media, communications, and discover. The Your Day tab will change its title depending on the time of day you're looking at it. So it'll say your morning, your afternoon, etc. It'll present various cards that Google thinks might be important to you, which can include cards that you can tap to play the news, show the weather, control specific smart devices, listen to news reports, etc. The home control control tab shows you the different devices in your home that you can control. It has a very large tile button to turn on and off the lights in the room that that device is in, as well as categories of devices in your home that you can quickly get to in the UI. If you're on the photo frame mode and swipe down from the top, this is the view you'll now get in the UI. The media tab will show you your media playing on different assistant speakers throughout your home, which is pretty cool, making it easy to control. Google will also show deep link tabs here too, where you'll be able to jump right into where you left off in a specific show instead of just opening up a specific service. The communication tab shows you information like calling household contacts, the ability to broadcast to a different speaker, or make a phone or video call using Google Duo. The Discover tab houses all of the different things the Google Assistant display can do that you can test out. But unlike before, these recommendations are more tailored to you, like showing you recipes you may want to make. Google is also now rolling out a dark mode that will turn on automatically depending on the time of day or the room's ambient light. Dark mode can also be manually selected by swiping up from the bottom of the display, tapping the gear icon, and then tap display, and then you'll be able to manually change your display to dark theme. Also, as reported by The Verge and other outlets, Google has stated that they are bringing the ability to see information from both your personal and work Google accounts at the same time on the display. So far, this hasn't rolled out to me just yet, but once it does, I'll be sure to demo it in an upcoming video. Next, let's take a look at the Google Assistant on Android for a second. Google has just released a pretty major feature called Shortcuts for the Google Assistant on Android. Shortcuts allow the Assistant to do things within apps installed on your Android phone, like compose a tweet, create a new Instagram post, share your location on Google Maps, etc. To get to the new Shortcuts settings page, open up the Google Assistant settings on an Android device. Then scroll down and select Shortcuts. You'll first see the Explore tab, which will recommend shortcuts you can add to your assistant from the apps you have downloaded on your Android phone. Once you add a shortcut, you do have the ability to edit the phrase you need to say in order for that shortcut to run. Here are a few examples of the new Shortcuts feature in action. Send an email. Tweet. YouTube subscriptions. Pretty cool. All right, next up is a really neat trick with the Google Assistant where the Google Assistant can try to identify that song you've got stuck in your head. So you can try humming the song, whistle, try to make pretty much any noise to replicate the song you've got stuck in your head and see if Google can identify it for you. Now, the way this works is you ask the Google Assistant, what song is this? And then proceed to hum that tune and then Google will identify it. Now, if you're really brave, you can even try singing the song to see if Google can identify the song you're trying to sing. Here's an example.
Sounds like it might be one of these.
Though my heart is falling through, I'm in love with your body. I hope you don't mind that I put down in words how wonderful I.
Well, I certainly won't be quitting my day job. Now, do note, I've only gotten this to work on my Android device by using the phrase, what's this song? On iOS, if you open the Google app and tap the Assistant button, there's a button that showed up for me to search a song. Next up, let's talk about how the Google Assistant can help you work from home, especially during times like these when there's a pandemic going on. Google has made it easier to break up your workday when you work from home by introducing a new Google Assistant routine called Workday. To get to it, open up the Assistant settings, scroll down to Routines, and then select the new Workday routine. This pre-made routine, which you have the ability to modify, can do things like tell you about the time, today's calendar events in the morning, as well as your reminders. Then throughout the day, you can have the assistant proactively remind you to tell you the time and that it's time to stand up and stretch, or time to get up and make lunch, or maybe even go take a break and have a walk. By default, it'll even give you a warning around 4:45 p.m. in your local time to start wrapping up your workday. All right, last update, and it's a quick one. Google, a month or two back, added a new on-off status for lights in your home in the Google Home app to make it easy to visually discern if they're on or off, and then be able to quickly turn them on or off from within the app. All right, well, that's it for the updates for this month. I hope you found this video helpful and informative. And if you like this video, make sure to hit that thumbs up button below and subscribe to the channel to see more Google videos and Google Assistant video updates like this one. For 6 months later, I'm Josh Tedder. Thanks for watching.